This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, everyone. In the last session, we discussed how to create branches in the GitHub and why we need branches in the GitHub repository. Right. So today we are going to work with how to push the changes to a particular branch, how to clone particular branch, and how to merge changes from one branch to another branch, and what is pull request and how to create a pull request in the Git repositories. All right, let's get started. So when we create Git repository in GitHub, we will get master branch by default. But only one branch is sufficient when multiple team members are working on the to support parallel development, we need to have branches in Git repository. What are the branches we need in the Git repository? So generally in real time, we will create several branches like below. So by default, master branch will come for us. That is a default branch we will call. We'll call it as a default branch. From that, people will create a develop branch. Some people will create future branches. Then QA branch will be available. UAT branch will be available. Then release branch also will be available for that. Now, for parallel work development, in the development area also, multiple sub teams will be available, like development, ongoing development team, bug fixing team, MNO teams will be available. So to support parallel development for all these teams, only one branch is not sufficient. If you have only one branch, it will confuse us like anything. Properly, we will not be able to release the functionality to the production. Sorry. Now, to avoid such kind of integration problems, we are going to maintain several branches, right? How to create branch in the Git repository right now? So already there is a repository which already contains our project files. Now, in this repository, we can see what are the branches available. So there are three branches available. One is master, second one is develop, third one is feature, right? When we are going to create feature branch, anybody can answer in the chat box. When we need to create feature branch in the Git repository? When we will create feature branch in the Git repository? Whenever you are going to work on a story, your task, whenever you are working on a story, then you need to create a feature branch. Right now, instead of disturbing the existing code, I want to code separately. Once my coding and testing is completed, then I will merge my changes with the main branches, which is like a develop branch or master branch, right? So in the company environment also, you will have the access for creating the branches. You no need to ask anybody to create the branch. You no need any permission also. By default, branch creation option will be available for your account right now. So today I'm going to work on a story called story number is 218. Today I need to start working with the 218. This story is going to take 3 days of time for me. This task is going to take 3 days of time for me. As part of these 3 days work, I'm going to write some code. I don't want to keep my code in the existing branches. I want to maintain my code in a separate branch with for my task. Then what I will do? So go to master branch. Whatever the code is available in the master branch, with that, I will create one branch with a name called feature. The code, the ID is suppose 200. My task ID is a 200 in the Jira. So I will create a branch with a name called feature-200. Feature, it is a new functionality. So here option is there, create branch feature 200 from the master. So from the master branch, we created a feature branch, right? Now, whatever the code that I need to do for my 200 task, I will do that code and I will keep my code inside the feature branch only. So for every story, I'm going to create one feature branch. Once my coding testing is completed, my feature branch changes, I will merge with the develop branch changes and I will delete my feature branch changes, right? We can create branches directly in the Git repository. In the github.com, we can create branches. In GitHub account, we can create branches in repository. We can create branches in repository, right? After creating the branches, now I need to clone the repository specific branch. Do you know how to clone a particular branch from the repository? Guys, can you help me? How to clone a particular branch from the repository? Clone branch from repository. So anybody tell me how to clone branch from the repository? Now here I'm going to keep a person name as a something like a Sanjay. Right. Now this person newly joined in the project, he need to work on that. He created a branch for his work and he need to clone that branch. So what is the command that he need to use to clone that particular branch? Git to clone URL or git to clone hyphen B branch name URL. Git to clone hyphen B branch name URL. If he directly use the clone command, it will clone from the master branch, but he should not touch the master branch for his development activity. So for his development activity, he created a branch called feature. He created a branch called feature, right? Now, so first copy the repository URL. Copy the repository URL. Now go to Sanjay folder, open Git bash. Open Git bash. Right. Git clone hyphen B space feature hyphen 200 space repository URL. Git clone hyphen B branch name repository URL. Click on enter. Now it is cloning from feature branch. It is cloning from feature branch. Right. Now cd space project name. Now you can check in which branch we are currently pointing. Git branch is giving the name as a feature 200. That means Sanjay cloned Git repository using feature branch 200. Now Sanjay has done the cloning. He has doing some modifications to the existing code. Let us see here. He is going to the boot start class. Now he changed something like this. He added one method here. He added one method here. Public void do process. Public void do process, something like this. He has written one method. This is part of story. This is part of CSL or HIS 200 related changes. Logic goes here. Now something logic is going to write here. Logic goes here. As part of the story 200 in the Jira, he has taken a story called 200. As for that story 200, he created one method called do process. Now this is required for the 200. Now where he need to commit his code, does he going to commit the code to the master branch or he will commit the code to the feature branch? He will commit the code to the feature branch. For this story only he created the feature branch, so he will commit that code to feature branch. Now let us see diagrammatically how it is going to happen. Right. Now already we are having a Git repository. Assume that this is our Git repo. Inside that Git repo, one master branch is available. Inside this, we are having a branch called master. Master branch is available. From this master branch, what this person has done? This person created one branch called feature branch. This person created one branch with the name called feature-200. So why he created a branch with a name called future-200? He is working on a story. That story ID is 200 in the Jira. Now from here to here, that got created. From here to here, that means whatever the code that is available in the master branch, that code is copied to feature branch. The feature branch name is future-200. Now here the developer, here the developer is available. He is Mr. Sanjay. He is working on the story number 200. Working on the story 200. His code changes will be committed to the feature branch. His code changes will be committed to feature branch. Code push. Sanjay. Let me give this person name as Sanjay. Right. This person pushed his code to feature branch 200. Right. Now, can you tell me how he will push the code to the feature branch? He can use Git bash or he can use IDE also. We felt Git bash is a little bit easier than working with that IDE. Right. Now, Git status. There is one file which is modified. There is one file which is modified. First, add that file to staging area. Add that file to staging area. Right. Now, Git status. That file is added to staging area. Right. Now, commit it. Then commit it. Git commit hyphen m his hyphen 200 changes. So he is committing these changes for a story with a name called his 200. Commit hyphen m, the reason for the commit we need to enter. Right. That file is committed. Now how to push that commit to repository? Git push. What is the option we need to use? Git push. Now, how many branches are there in the repository? There are multiple branches. There are multiple branches available. To which branch this code will be pushed now? To which branch this code will be pushed now? Feature branch, because currently he cloned from the feature branch. So it is pointing to this feature 200 branch only. So this code will be pushed to feature branch only. This will not be pushed to master, guys. Please remember. Sanjay is the developer who cloned the repository from this feature 200 branch. Why? Because he is going to work on a story called feature. As part of that feature, he need to maintain his code separately. He don't want to disturb the existing functionality of the project. He don't want to disturb the existing code of the project. That's why he cloned that branch and he started working on that branch. Now here he has done the push. He has done the push. Now his changes will be reflected into Git central repository of feature 200 branch. In the feature 200 branch, this Sanjay changes are going to reflect. Sanjay changes are going to reflect. Now verify his changes are reflecting or not. Currently select in which branch we are. Currently it is pointing to feature 200. Go to SRC. Go to main folder. Go to that boot start class. He added a method called do process. Yes, perfect. That method is able to display. We are able to see that method in the Git central repository that is available for the feature 200 branch. Now let us go to master branch and verify, is the do process method available or not? Now here I'm selecting how to switch, right? Here I'm selecting the drop down, selecting a branch called master. Now it is pointed to master branch. It is pointed to master branch. SRC main web application. Is the do process method available or do process method is not available? Do process method is not available because Sanjay committed to feature branch. The changes which are committed to the feature branch are not reflected to the master branch. Now, with the work doing by the Sanjay, is there any impact on the existing functionality? With the changes done by the Sanjay, with the changes committed by the Sanjay, is there any impact in the existing code? There is no impact. That's the reason. Whenever we are working on any task, we will create our own feature branches for our task. Our work should not disturb others' work. Our work should not disturb others' work. So that is the reason. It is very, very recommended to create your feature branches when you are working on a story. When you are working on a story. Now assume that this Sanjay completed his work. whatever the changes that he has to do, he completed that work, he tested. Now he is confident. Now he is confident about his code. Now he want to keep his code to the master branch. That is called merging changes from one branch to another branch. Merging changes from one branch to another branch. Now, what this Sanjay has to do? What this Sanjay has to do is, he need to merge the changes of the feature branch to master branch. He has to merge the changes of the feature branch to master branch. Merge the changes from the feature branch to master branch. Right. This is called branch merging. This is called branch merging. When Sanjay will merge the changes from feature branch to the master branch, whenever Sanjay development is completed, Sanjay unit testing is completed, if Sanjay is confident on his code, then that person will merge the changes to master branch. Right? Now, Sanjay is going to merge his code into master branch. Right? Now, if Sanjay is confident about his functionality is completed, if testing is completed, if everything is perfect, then he can merge, he will merge his code from feature branch to master branch. After merging the changes from feature branch to master, Sanjay can delete that feature branch also. Then there is no use of that feature branch. Then there is no use of that feature branch. Now see here how to merge the changes from one branch to another branch. Right. Fine. It is a development task only, sir. Just unit testing. That's it. Fine. Clone branch from repository. Make changes and push your changes to branch which you created for your feature. Make changes and push your changes to branch which you create for your feature. Now, once your development and unit testing is completed, then merge your changes to master branch or develop branch, whatever the branch it is. Change your changes to master branch or develop branch, whatever the branch that is there. So you can merge your changes to main branch. Now, how to merge the changes? To merge changes from one branch to another branch, we will create pull request. So now Sanjay pushed changes to feature 200. His changes are completed now. He is confident about his code. Now he want to merge his code to master branch. How to merge changes from one branch to another branch? We will create a pull request. Right. Whenever we create a pull request to merge it, the Git is going to compare the source branch and the target branch. The source branch and target branch will be compared. What is the source now? Source is the feature. What is the target? Target is the master. From source branch to target branch, from feature branch to master branch, we are going to merge the changes by creating a pull request. Sir, who will create a pull request in the project? Which developer wants to merge the changes, that developer is going to create a pull request. Now, this is a Sanjay branch, right? Sanjay coding is completed. Sanjay has to merge the changes to master. Now, Sanjay will go to the GitHub or Bitbucket. Sanjay will create a pull request. He will select what is the source branch and what is the target branch also, right? Now, go to this account, select this Sanjay branch name, which is feature 200. Select this branch with a name called feature 200, right? Now, so the Git is saying that, boss Sanjay, you created a new branch from the master, then you have done some changes to that new branch which you created, but those changes are not there in your branch where you copied. That changes are not there in your master from where you copied the code. Do you want to merge your changes? Right now, it is displaying you recently pushed branches is feature 6 minutes ago. What it is saying? Compare and pull request. So Compare your future branch with the master branch. If required, create a pull request to pull the changes from one branch to another branch. Right, now let me click on this application option, compare and create pull request. Right, here, observe carefully. Sir, whatever we are discussing, everything is exactly same in the Bitbucket also. Everything is exactly same in the Bitbucket. Just here we are using github.com, there we will use bitbucket.com. Other than that, no other difference. Everything is same. Now, base branch is the master and the source branch is the feature. Source branch is the feature and base branch is the master. Now, what I am doing? I am merging the changes which are available in the feature branch to the master branch by opening a pull request. Create a new pull request by comparing changes across two branches. If you need to, you can also compare across forks also. If there is a fork, then also you can compare. We discussed about what is fork, right? Fork means read-only permission we will give for the people. We don't want to allow them to commit the changes to our branch directly, right? Now, feature branch is available. Feature branch code, master branch code is compared. Git identified that, yes, you can merge it, able to merge. There is no chance of getting the conflicts. You can merge it. First, I will show you a happy scenario. Then I will show you problem scenario also. Next example I will take, which will give you conflict problem. Then I will tell you how to resolve that conflict also. First, let me complete this happy scenario. Whatever the code is there in the feature branch, that can happily merge it with the master branch. That is the reason Git is saying, able to merge. Now, these branches can be automatically merged. That means there is no problem, sir. If you want, you can merge it. Right. Now, create pull request. If you want, you can write a comment also. Then create pull request. Yes, fine. We created pull request. We created a pull request, right? Here, there is an option called merge pull request. Now click on merge pull request. Here it is asking confirm merge, right? I'm merging. Merging means copy the changes from this branch to that branch. Comment merging feature 200 branch changes to master. Merging feature 200 branch changes to master, then comment it. Then comment request, pull request successfully merged and closed. Then what are the changes available in the feature 200? You are all set. What are the changes you push it to the feature 200? Those changes are merged to master. Branch can be safely deleted. My future 200 task code is completed. That code is merged to the master branch. Now, delete branch. I don't need it now. For next task, I will create one more future. That's not a problem. Right? Branch is deleted. Now, go to our repository. First, check what are the branches available. Is the future 200 branch available or it is not available? The future 200 branch is not available because we deleted that. Now, go to the master branch and open that file where we modified src main that start class of the boot. See, that method is reflected in the master branch or method is not reflected in the master branch. That method is reflecting in the master branch. Why? Because we created a pull request and we merged our branches. We merged the code from one branch to another branch. Successfully, we are able to execute our pull request. Are you able to follow this? This is the positive scenario. First, what the work we have done? We created Git repository. In that, by default, master branch will come. There is some code done by the developers available in the project and that code is available in the master. Now, I want to work on a story called 200. HAS200 is my Jira ID. For that story, I don't want to disturb the code available in the repository. I don't want to spoil the existing functionality. I am going on trial and error method. So that's why instead of directly making the changes to the master, I will create one copy branch that is called as a feature 200. Whatever the code is there in the master, that will come to my feature. Right. after this. So 2 days or 3 days, I'm working on the changes. I pushed my changes to feature. I tested, everything is working fine. I'm very happy. Now I am confident my code can be merged with the existing branch. How the code will be merged from one branch to another branch? That's where pull request comes into picture. By creating a pull request, we will merge the changes from one branch to another branch. After pull request execution got completed successfully, then we can delete our branch also. That is not required. Are you able to follow this one? How to create a pull request and how to merge the changes from one branch to another branch by executing pull request? Let me write a few points for this. To merge changes from one branch to another branch, we will create pull request, right? When we execute pull request, GitHub compares source branch and target branch. Source branch and target branch, and will confirm can we merge these branches or not, and it will confirm can we merge these branches or not. And it is going to confirm can we merge these branches or not. So as of now, it is showed as a status called able to merge. That means we can merge the branches happily, no problem, right? We can merge the changes or not. If status is able to merge, then execute pull request and merge changes, right? After pull request execution got completed, we can delete new branch that we created. We can delete that new branch which we created for our story. Just read these points, all of you guys. Once go through these points. All of you go through these points. We completed branches. How to create a branch? Why? First, we understood what is branch. Why? How to create the branches? Why we need branches? How to commit clone particular branch? How to push to particular branch? And how to clone that particular branch? And how to push the changes to that branch? Then we have seen how to merge the changes from one branch to another branch also by using pull request. In the real time, daily, we are going to see these kind of operations. completed. Lock you. Now, let me take one more scenario where pull request will fail. Let me take one scenario where pull request is going to fail. If all of you confident about this pull request execution, then we will take another scenario where I will show you the problems in the execution of pull request. Right. All of you clear about what is pull request and how to create pull request and how to merge branches? Please confirm. Right. Now we are going to do operation once again. Same operation I am going to do once again. Now this time I will show you failure scenario. First scenario I have shown you successful scenario. Successfully we are able to merge the changes from one branch to another branch by using pull request. Now I will show you failure scenario. Right. Now real time use case. Scenario, use case, real time scenario. Fine. Two developers are working in the project. Two developers are working on sprint. Two developers are working on sprint something like 7.3. Two developers are working on sprint 7.3. Tell me two names of developer names. I need the names to explain you more clearly who is doing what. Which name we can take? Dilip, Mark and Steve. Dilip and Saurav. Okay. We'll take Dilip and Saurav. Fine. Two developers are working on sprint 7.3. So these are the two developers working. Each developer working on different story. Each developer working on different story. Dilip and Saurav are the developers. Dilip and Saurav are the developers. Now, Dilip is working on a story. Dilip working on Dilip working on HAS 300 story. Right. Now, so here other developer Saurav working on HAS 301 story. So in the sprint there are two stories available. I mean several stories are there. These two people started working with these two stories. One is HAS 300 story, another one is HAS 301 story. Now, what is the recommended approach? Now, our project is having master branch and our project is having develop branch. Right. Now, assume that latest code is available in the develop branch. Now, the latest code, they are working on the development, right? For development, right? For development purpose, they are going to use dev branch. They are going to use a develop branch. Now, first, let me set up develop branch in the repository. Go to this project now. We are having develop branch. We are having this branch is committed ahead, two commits behind master. Right. Now here we are having a develop branch. Right. Now, so latest code available in develop branch. Note, latest code is available in develop branch. Right. Now let me take the diagram for this one. First we have a branch called master. First we have a branch with the name called master. First we have a branch with the name called master. Right. Now from the master branch, right, team lead told that we need to do the development for 7.3 in a branch called dev branch. We need to do development in a branch called develop branch. This is for R7.3 development. R7 point development for release. 7.3. For release 7.3, we need to use a branch called develop branch, right? So the developers, Dilip and Saurav, has to keep their code in the develop branch. They need to keep the code in the develop branch, right? Now, in this scenario, what is the recommended approach? Now, Dilip has to start working on a story called HAS 300. Saurav has to work on a story called HAS 301. Now, tell me, what is the recommended approach? Will you ask both to work on the same branch, or is it recommended to create separate feature branches for their stories? I need your answers. What is recommended? Separate individual branches creation is recommended, because one developer code should not disturb other developer code. One developer code should not disturb other developer code. So like this, Dilip and Saurav, if there are other five members also in the team, so one branch will confuse like anything. So separate branches maintaining is recommended when they are working on different stories. They are working on different stories. Now, what these people has to do is, now here from develop branch, Saurav is going to create one feature branch. From the develop branch, Saurav is going to create one feature branch based on his story. His story number is 301. Dilip is going to create one branch with a story call for the story call 300. So here Dilip will name this branch as a feature iPhone 300. Now, at the same time, this Saurav also created one more branch with a name called feature 301. Like this, two separate branches are created from the develop branch. Now, for these feature branches, what is the base branch? The base branch is the develop branch. All the code that is doing for the release 7.3 should be available in this develop branch only. But now these two people created their own branches. Now Saurav created the branch for this 301. He created a branch 301. Here Dilip created a branch 300 for his story name, for his story ID 300. He is maintaining a feature branch. For his story, Saurav is maintaining a separate feature branch. This is actually recommended in the industry, right? When you are working on any story, you create a separate branch for your story and you do your development there. Once your development and testing is completed, then you need to merge your changes to your base branch. What is the base branch for these two branches now? From which branch these two branches are created? Come on, guys. From which branch these two branches are created? By looking at the diagram, you can easily answer. From which branch these two feature branches are created? These feature branches are created from develop branch. So what is the base branch for these two branches? Develop branch. So once the work is completed by Dilip and Saurav, where they need to merge the changes? They need to merge the changes to develop branch, because they created these feature branches from the develop branch. Once their changes are completed, they need to merge their changes to develop branch only. Right. Now, first, let's start creating the branches for these two people. Now, I'm going to act as a Dilip for 5 minutes of time. Now, treat me as a Dilip for 5 minutes of time. So, branch develop is available. Now, I want to create a new branch. Right. Now, my story name is feature. My story name is 300. ID is 300. So, I created a branch for my story with a name called feature 300. Create branch feature 300 from the develop. From the development branch, I'm creating feature 300. Completed. Now, what I need to do? I need to clone which branch now? I need to clone feature 300 branch. I need to clone feature 300 branch, because now I am a Dilip. So as a Dilip, I need to clone the feature 300 branch. Right. So do you know how to clone a particular branch? Do you know how to clone a particular branch? Come on, do you know how to clone a particular branch? Yes, we know how to clone a particular branch. To clone a particular branch, we need to give git clone hyphen b branch name URL. Git clone hyphen b branch name URL. Now, let me create one folder with a name called Dilip. Dilip, right. Fine. Open git bash. git clone hyphen b branch name feature 300 space repository URL. Guys, observe carefully. Repository URL. I'm not going to repeat this once again. This is the second time we are going to do. Git clone hyphen b branch name repository URL. Dilip has done clone. Dilip has done some cloning. Now Dilip is pointing to which branch? Let us check it. Git branch. Sorry. Go inside this folder. CD Spring application. Now git branch. Dilip is pointing to feature branch. Let's close this. Fine. Done. Now let me act like a Sanjay. Let me act like a Sanjay. So what this Sanjay will do? Sorry, not Sanjay, Saurav. So Dilip work is completed now. I'm going to work like a Saurav. Let me treat as Saurav for next 5 minutes of time. So what I will do as a Saurav, I need to create one branch for my task. I need to create one branch for my task, right? So let me create a folder. Let me create a folder as a Saurav. Create a folder as a Saurav. Now open git bash. Open git bash. So what this person has to do, he has to clone it. Git clone hyphen b, git clone hyphen b feature. Is that created feature? Is the branch created? No. First I need to create the branch, right? From where I need to create the branch? From the develop I need to create it. Please remember guys, Dilip also created from the develop, Saurav also going to create from the develop, right? Now enter the branch name feature hyphen 301. Feature hyphen 301, that is the story ID in the Jira. Create branch 301 from the develop. So these two people created branches from the base branch called develop. With this, both people are done. Branches are created. Now let's Saurav clone this repository. Feature hyphen 301, then pass repository URL. Git clone hyphen b feature 301. Right. Now cd space Spring Boot app git branch feature 301. So Saurav is pointing to 301 branch and Dilip is pointing to 300 branch. Guys, all of you clear with the operation what I have done? Now I am a polymorphic person. Sometimes I am behaving like a Saurav, sometimes I am behaving like a Dilip. So but in the real time, as two people are going to work, this much confusion will not be there for you, because you will be act like yourself. You will create a branch for your story. But here I am doing both works. Few minutes I am working like a Dilip, few minutes I am working like a Saurav. Don't get confused with that. But assume that two people are working on this. All of you clear with this one? Still anybody has any confusion in creating the branches? Anybody has any confusion in creating the branches? No. Perfect. Right. Now these two people started their development activities. These two people started their development activities. Right. Let me close it. Now two people started dev activity. Two people started dev activity. Now this is, please don't unmute. Please don't unmute. Mute your mics. Mute your mics. Right. Now here the persons, both developers started their development task. Both developers started their development task. Now both developers started their development task. So daily they are writing some code and they are pushing their code to the repository. They are pushing the code to repository. Both developers, they are doing some coding and they are pushing the changes to their branch. So to which branch they will push? To the respective branch. Dilip will push the changes to feature 300 branch. Saurav will push the changes to feature 301 branch. Are you able to understand? Because they are working on two different stories. So for their story, they created a branch separately. Right. Now let me push some changes from delete. Let me push some changes from Dilip system. Now assume that I am Dilip now. So go to src main java open that boot main class. Open the main class. Right. Now, after the line of the main method, after the main method, sorry, after the class line, there is no code available. Here, he declared one constant, private static final string, final static string rest URL. Final static string rest URL, one constant is declared, he specified HTTP //www.equifax.com/getscores. So this is on third party REST API URL. Right. Now, what Dilip has done is, Dilip configured one class level variable in the boot start class. Right. Now, where he configured? Immediately after the line of the class. Right. If I open in the notepad++, you will understand the line number. You will understand this line number. Right. Fine. So Dilip has made a change to the file at the eighth line. Dilip has made the changes to the boot start class at the eighth line. He added a REST URL variable, which is a third party web service endpoint URL, third party REST API endpoint URL. Right. Now, so assume that like this, he has done some work in all the files. He has done with his changes. He has done with these changes. He has done some more coding also. Fine. Just I added one line of code. Fine. Assume that Dilip has done his work. Now, what is the duty of the Dilip now? Once his work is completed. What is the duty of the Dilip now? Once his work is completed. Now, assume that he has done lot of changes. He has done lot of changes. Now, I made some change. What Dilip has to do now? Dilip has to perform three operations. Dilip has to perform three operations. Dilip has to commit, Dilip has to push, Dilip has to merge it. Are you able to understand? Now assume that Dilip code is completed. So Dilip has to commit his code, Dilip has to push the code to the branch which he created, then he need to merge the changes from his feature branch to the base branch called develop branch. Are you able to follow this? Now can I do that operation? Can I do that operation from the Dilip system? Now I am Dilip, assume that. Guys, this much explanation you don't get in the internet also. If you sleep, then I am not responsible. Nobody will explain you this much clearly with the scenarios. Git tool. If you really work in the Git tool, then only you will understand this much of explanation. Then only you can give this much of explanation. Please utilize this properly. Don't sleep in the middle. You can't understand this scenario anywhere else outside. Right. Now. So Dilip has to push the changes to the repository, and Dilip has to merge the changes from feature branch to the base branch called develop. Right. Open git bash from the Dilip folder. Now I'm pointing to this Dilip folder. Open git bash. Git status. One file is modified by Dilip. Let's commit it by adding git add --a git commit -m message. HAS 300 changes. HAS -300 is a story ID in the Jira. HAS 300 related changes. Related changes. Now git push those changes. Push it to feature branch 300 by Dilip. Right. With this, Dilip is pushing his changes. Go and check in the repository. Go and check in the repository. Go to the branch call 300. Go to the branch call 300. SRC main Java where the start class is available. Go to the start class. See that in the eighth line, Dilip change is reflecting in the central repository. In the eighth line, Dilip change is reflecting in the central repository. In which branch that change is there? That branch is there in the feature 300. Now let us check with this change will be. Does this change will be available in the Saurav branch or will not be available in the Saurav branch? This change will be available in the Saurav branch or will not be available in the Saurav branch? Verify and see that. With our eyes, we need to see that. Go to start class. Go to start class. Now see at the eighth line. Is there any code available at the eighth line in the 301 branch? This branch is created by Saurav. In the 301 branch, the code is not available because Dilip pushed the change to only 300 branch. Now tell me, does this code done by the Dilip will be available in the developed branch or will not be available in the developed branch? Will be available in the developed branch or will not be available in the developed branch? This code will not be available in the developed branch. Now tell me what Dilip has to do to move this code to the developed branch. Now what Dilip has to do move this code to the developed branch? Dilip has to merge it. How to merge the changes from one branch to another branch? How to merge the changes from one branch to another branch? By creating a pull request. By creating a pull request. Now let's verify. Go to this branch called 300. Go to this branch called 300. Right. It is saying that 2 minutes ago there is a push. You recently pushed branches is 300. Now compare and pull request. Compare and pull request. Now which branch it is going to compare? Now I am going to compare to the develop. Now I am going to compare to the develop. Why? Because I created my feature branch from the develop branch. So I will merge this feature branch changes to the develop branch only. I will merge the changes from feature branch to the develop branch only. Right. Now this is develop branch and this is my master branch. Now here Dilip is going to create a pull request for this operation. Dilip is going to create a pull request for this operation. Create pull request. Create pull request, merge it. Pull request and merge operation. So from feature branch, Dilip is going to merge the changes to base branch, which is called develop. Whenever Dilip created a pull, trying to create a pull request, it is comparing. We need to select which one you need to compare with which base. What is the base? Base is develop, because Dilip created a branch from the develop branch, able to merge. These branches can be automatically merged. That means there is no problem. It is also a happy scenario. Dilip is not facing any problem. Dilip is happily can merge his changes from feature branch to the develop branch. Leave a comment. HAS 300 story related changes merged from feature 300 branch to develop branch. From feature 300 branch to the develop branch. Create a pull request. Changes are ability for merge. They are able to merge automatically. Click on merge pull request. Confirm merge. Confirm merge. Rise. Nice. Changes are merged from feature 300 to develop. Now, is there any need of this branch for the Dilip? Dilip work is completed. Now, does he need to maintain this branch or no need to maintain this branch? I need answers. Does he need to maintain or no need to maintain? Right? No need to maintain. Then why unnecessarily we need to keep it this branch? Let's click on delete. Now that branch got deleted. Now that branch got deleted. Now where I can check whether this code is reflected or not? Where I need to check whether this code is reflected or not? In the develop branch. Go to develop branch. Go to develop branch. SRC. Main. Go to start class. And verify eighth line is changed or not changed. Eighth line. Earlier in the develop branch, eighth line was empty. Now the changes which are done by the Dilip, those changes are successfully merged to develop branch. Successfully Dilip work is completed. He created a new branch for his task. He has done his changes. He tested. He merged his changes from that future branch to develop branch. With this, his work is completed. Now, think about Saurav. Now, Saurav is also working on the same kind of work, right? Saurav has created a new branch. Now, Saurav has to do some changes for his story called 301. So, where the Saurav is going to do? Where the Saurav is going to do? Saurav is going to do the changes in the 301 branch. From where he created the 301 branch? He also created the 301 branch from the develop. Now, whatever the code that is there in the Saurav system, whatever the code that is there in the dev branch, is it same or is it not same? The code that is there in the develop branch, the code that is there in the Saurav branch, is it same or it is not same? Come on, not same, because Dilip merged the changes to develop. What are the changes merged by the Dilip? Those changes are not available in the Saurav branch. Now Saurav is working on his story 301. Saurav is working on his story called 301. Now let me do some changes as Saurav. Right. Now go to Saurav folder. Go to Saurav folder. Now let me close this Dilip work. Now I'm moving to Saurav folder. Now I'm working like a Saurav. Go to SRC, same file. SRC, same file. In the same file, let me open this file. Right. Now, after the line of the main class, do you have any line in the Saurav system? We don't have. Whenever he created this branch, that line was empty. That line was empty. Now, here, Saurav started doing one method, public void load data to cache. So whenever application starts, as per his story, he want to load the data to the cache. Now here he's writing some logic. He's writing some logic. Now in order to load the data to the cache, what Saurav needs is, Saurav needs one map, private map string comma object, string comma object cache, cache is equal to new hash map. Cache is equal to new hash map, string comma object, string comma object, string comma object. Now, so what Saurav is thinking, Saurav needs to load the data to the cache. So cache, we are using local cache as a map, map we are using as a local cache. So Saurav wants to store the data to the cache. So here logic will be available to retrieve the data from the database, static tables data he will retrieve from the database, and he will load the data to the map. So for storing the data to the map, first he need to create the map. So he thought that after this class, there is no other code available. So he created this line, he created this eighth line. At the eighth line, he kept this map object creation, map object creation. Right. Now Saurav thought that his work is completed. Now this work really is, assume that his work is completed. He implemented this method. This is related to HAS 301 changes, story ID. For this method, he need this variable. Map object is required. So he created the map at the eighth line. Now, after work is completed by Saurav, what this person has to do? Could you please tell me now? Saurav also completed his development and testing. He is successfully able to load the data to the cache. His work is completed successfully. Now, what is the duty of the Saurav? He has to commit, he has to push, and he has to merge by creating a pull request. Now, can I perform those operations? Can I perform those operations now? Right. Let us open Git Bash. Let us open Git Bash. Right. Git status. That boot main class is modified. Boot main class is modified. Git add double hyphen a, file is added. Git commit hyphen m has hyphen 301 related changes. That is the comment giving. So people when they look at this, they should understand why I modified this. So I modified because of this story related changes. Committed. Now git push. So now Saurav changes will be reflected in the central repository. Saurav changes will reflect in the central repository. Push is completed. Go to our git, check in the Saurav branch, which is 301. Go to src main method, boot start class. Now what is there in the eighth line? In the eighth line, we are having a map object creation. Now what is the pending task for the Saurav? Saurav task is completed. Now what this Saurav has to do now, he has to create a pull request and he has to merge it. He has to create a pull request and he has to merge it. From which branch he has to merge to which branch? Could you please tell me the names of the branch? From which branch he has to merge to which branch? Come on. From which branch he has to merge to which branch? He has to merge from 301 future branch to the develop branch. Right. Now, let us try to create a pull request for this. Let us see, can Saurav merge this pull request or can Saurav execute this pull request or Saurav cannot execute this pull request? So here, 1 minute ago, changes are committed to 301 branch. Compare and pull request. Click on this compare. So to from where to where you need to merge it? From future 301 to, he has to merge to develop. From future 301 to, he has to merge to develop. Now see the status, cannot automatically merge. Cannot automatically merge. Now tell me why this is showing that it is cannot merge automatically. What is the reason for that? What is the reason for that? Type in the chat box. Why this is Saurav cannot merge the changes from 301 branch to the develop branch? There is a conflict. In the develop branch, in that class, in the boot main class at the 8th line, Dilip is added one constant rest variable, rest URL variable is added. But whatever Saurav is trying to do, Saurav is trying to add a map object creation at the 8th line. So same line number, same line number. Dilip is added one rest URL variable. Saurav is adding one map variable. When I am trying to merge the changes from Saurav system to the dev system, I mean Saurav branch to the dev branch, this is saying that boss, 8th line already having some code, but you are asking me to keep some other code in the 8th line. I cannot do that. This is a conflict. This is called conflict. When multiple developers are working on the same file in the same line number, then conflicts will occur in the repository. At the time of Dilip is creating a pull request, no problem, because at that time there is nothing new in the dev branch. Dilip is able to merge the code by modifying the 8th line in the bootstrap class. But by the time Saurav starts creating the pull request, Dilip already merged the changes to dev branch. In that file, 8th line is already having a variable. But this Saurav is already, Saurav is added another variable at the 8th line in the same file, he is trying to merge with the dev branch. Now, within the same line, can I keep these two variables? No. That is the reason this GitHub is saying that boss, I cannot merge automatically. Don't worry, you can still create the pull request. Don't worry, still you can create the pull request. What it is saying that? Dangerous, but still you can go. It is dangerous, but still you can go. Cannot automatically merge it, but still you can create the pull request. That is the warning is given to Saurav. There is a warning is given to Saurav. Now, here I will write a comment. Merging. But please, don't neglect. This is very, very, very important scenario. In the interview, they will ask this question for 100%. How to merge pull request? What you will do when there is a conflict while you are creating pull request? Now observe what I am going to do. Merging feature 301 branch changes to develop. Merging feature 301 branch changes to develop. Create pull request. I know that it is not going to merge because there is a problem. What is the problem also we understood. Now see here, this branch has a conflict that must be resolved. This branch having conflict that must be resolved. In this class, there is a conflict. In this class, there is a conflict. Now, there is an option called resolve conflicts. Resolve conflicts. Now click on resolve conflicts. Now see, what is the problem? Now conflict occurred in our code. No conflict occurred in our code, right? Because two people are trying to keep the code in the same line. So that's why GitHub is not allowing to merge the changes from Saurav branch to the develop branch. When conflict occurred in our code, these kind of junk characters are going to generate. These kind of junk characters are going to generate. These kind of junk characters are called as, these kind of junk characters are called as conflicts in the code. Whenever you are merging the changes from one branch to another branch, then you may get conflicts like this. You may get conflicts like this. Are you able to follow this, all of you? Whenever we are merging changes from one branch to another branch, there is a chance of getting conflicts. There is a chance of getting conflicts. Now, what we need to do? So believe me, in the repositories, in the version controls, there is no automatic option to resolve the conflicts. There is no automatic option to resolve the conflicts. Manually, you need to resolve the conflict. Manually, we need to resolve the conflict. How we will resolve the conflicts manually? Now, I will edit this file. I will remove these junk characters. I will remove these junk characters. I will remove these junk characters. Now, I will keep these two variables. Both variables are required. For Saurav, cache variable is required. For Dilip, rest URL variable is required. I cannot delete it. So, but I will change the order of the lines. Either rest URL I will keep first or cache URL I will keep first. But both variables are required for the functionality. Then Dilip functionality will work and my functionality. As a Saurav, my functionality also going to work. Right. Now, I resolve these conflicts. I resolve these conflicts manually. After resolving these conflicts manually, so here in the only one line we got the conflict, but there is a chance we'll get the conflict in multiple lines also. There is a chance we will get conflicts in the multiple lines. If both people are doing the changes in the same lines, there is a chance of getting conflicts in the multiple lines. But here, two people have done the changes in the same line at the one place. So that's why we got one conflict. Now I resolve that conflict manually, then I'm marking as resolved. Mark as resolved. Once I click on this button, mark as resolved, then it is allowing me to commit this merge. There is a button called commit merge. Commit merge. Now, with this, that merge is committed. Checking for ability to continuous integration has not been set up. That means Jenkins is not available. No problem. Right. Merge this pull request. Now, is it allowing me to merge it or it is not allowing me to merge it? This branch has no conflicts with the base branch. Merging can be performed automatically. Now I can merge these changes from Saurav branch to the develop branch. Click on merge pull request. Confirm this merge. Confirm this merge. Now, as a Saurav, do I need this 301 branch or I don't need this 301 branch? Confirm. Do I need this branch or I don't need this branch? I don't need this branch because already my changes are merged with the base branch called develop branch. Now I am going to delete this branch. Now I'm going to delete this branch. That branch got deleted. Branch got deleted. Now check that our changes are available in the develop branch or changes are not available in the develop branch. Now go to branch called develop. Go to the branch called develop. I selected a branch called develop. Now go to src. Go to main. Go to the start class where it is available. This is my start class. Now check it. Both developer's code is available in the develop branch. Both developers' code is available in the develop branch. Whatever the code Dilip has done in this branch, he merged it. Whatever the code Saurav has done, that code is also available in the develop branch. This is how we are going to merge the changes from one branch to another branch. So to merge the changes from one branch to another branch, we are going to create a pull request. Whenever you are executing the pull request, there is a chance of getting the conflict. If there is a chance of conflict, then we need to resolve the conflict manually and we need to merge the changes by using that pull request. Once our pull request got executed successfully, we can delete our branch which we created for our story. So now in the real time also, every day, what I will do is, whenever I'm going to work on a story, I will create a future branch for my story. Once my changes are completed in the future branch, then I will merge my changes with the base branch. After my changes are merged with the base branch, I will delete my branch. I will delete my branch. Got it. So with this, we got the crystal clear clarity. What is a branch? Why we need to create the branches? How to create the branches? How to clone particular branch? How to push the change to a branch? How to create a pull request? Why to create a pull request? And how to merge changes from one branch to another branch? And when we will get the conflict problem? And how to resolve the conflict problem also we understood. All of you. Thank you.